This is somewhere around 1950. Mother Joan and I. Joan and I at Queensland Beach. Mother at the Wagwaltig, probably in 1949 or 1950. Wintertime at Queensland Beach. Joan on her sled at Gore's Brook. Mother standing at the top of the hill. Father was taking the pictures on this day, probably. That I remember very well. That was the first year on skates at the site of where Dalhousie is now. This is quite vivid. I remember this one. My Toronto Maple Leaf sweater. Now there's Father with his pride and joy, the blue wing. He's putting the finishing touches on the stern there. That was again in probably in the early 50s. This is at the Armdale Yacht Club. It's Father again painting the mooring with Joan, I believe. There's Joan. The man with Father about to bump his head is a good friend of Father's, Ron Smith. Sailed with Father a lot. Just a little glimpse of, I think, my 7th or 8th birthday party. Taken at Dalhousie. We're back to the Blue Wing now. Thank you. is the captain on board. Ron Smith at the on the sidelines there. This is yours truly on Chestnut Street. So that would be very early, probably in, again, 1950. This was something that got in there. Actually, this was mother and father's trip away for three or four days to Sheet Harbor on a fishing trip. Joan and I in the public gardens, feeding the pigeons. Joan on Chestnut Street. A mother at her old land in Herring Cove at that time, I believe. Or it may be it is Herring Cove. Roy with the boat, the Gee Whiz. Little 8-foot pram had a mast on it and sails. That was again in the probably 1951-52. I know I couldn't swim at this point. Now there's Joan swimming. Joan learned to swim probably 3 or 4 years old. She certainly was the first one to swim between her and I. This was some photography by mother. Of a dragonfly on the garage door on Chestnut Street. I think she probably took about 3 minutes of film of this. And this was Armdale Yacht Club, as it used to be. This is Mother at Chester. With the brood there. That was Father's Labor of Love, the back garden. And this is on Purcells Cove Road, where they still live, at 120 Purcells Cove Road. Father used to commute from Ottawa to work in the garden, it seemed, at that time. good shot of Joan and Mother. Mother at Peggy's Cove. We used to go there quite often, actually. Winter and summer. And that's one thing that hasn't changed. Peggy's Cove, still pretty well the same. This is Herring Cove again in the winter time. Joan and Smokey. I think that this was behind her house on Pine Haven Road. Mother and Joan on Pine Haven. That's something else that hasn't changed. Mother up on the lookout. Dingle Tower behind there in Halifax, as it appeared in early 50s. That's the only photograph on record of Roy working. but he did lay at least 2 stones on that patio. 3 stones. That is the Can family that lived next door, John Can and Louise Can, Mary Lou, Joan's friend, and Paula. Roy and his codfish that was taken on the same weekend that mother and father went on their fishing trip to Liscombe Lodge or Sheet Harbor. This is Hilda Armitage and Kenneth Armitage and Karen Armitage, who lived right across the street from my parents, from mother and father. And the garden has never looked as good. They're doing a little rolling there. Everybody's doing a little rolling there. My father looks in good spirits. Steward Ronald, he's now captain of a ferry boat going from Nanaimo, British Columbia, to Victoria. This is again mother and father's trip to Sheet Harbor. That's the guide that Father had at that time. Mother and Father had a guide down there. And this is sailing on the northwest arm. Mother at Queensland. This is earlier, actually. This is Joan and I in Lunenburg. And I think this was, well, this was definitely before the last sequence. Because we're back at Chestnut Street now. Unfortunately, this mother up in the balcony at Chestnut Street, tending her flower boxes. I think there was a lot of snapdragons then. This was 4 1/2 Chestnut Street where we lived. This was that swimming hole on the St. Margaret's Bay Road, and now we're again in Peggy's Cove. Mother's wearing my favorite skirt that she had. And Father looking really dapper in his bow tie and brown shoes. That is Joan or I in my Mountie uniform. I thought it was me, but it looks a bit like Joan. And this is Peggy's Cove on a very stormy day. Now this is some footage of Father's, possibly off Bermuda. Looks pretty cold for Bermuda. But this is some footage I'm not familiar with. There's a submarine there in the background. Joan on the slopes. Joan did a lot of skiing. Actually, we both did. And that's one of the family, the next door neighbor's dog, Carol Grant's dog, Lassie. Thank you. This is the Cairns house next door, looking from our backyard, looking over. His mother at our lot in Herring Cove. Rainy Hopkins, Rainy and Joan, with a litter of kittens from, I presume, one of our cats. We had Smokey and Fifi. That was probably Fifi one. It's Harrop's store and our old Pontiac with the McKay's house under construction. It's a view of the backyard before the landscaping was done. This again, I think, is out of sequence. This is Joan and Mary Lou. And mother. Father looking dapper again, I think on his way sailing. This is the Escazoni, J.C. McKean's boat that Father used to sail on. Great deal of time. And this is Roy in his Cub uniform. We've skipped a few years here. Now, this is in Ottawa, when Mother drove us up to Ottawa to spend some time with Father. I don't have the date of this. Again, it was probably the mid-50s. Father and I in Ottawa at the War Memorial. Joan at the War Memorial. Thank you. hotel in Ottawa that we stayed at, and I don't remember the name of it. And we're back home again, mother in her summer hat. No, we're back in Ottawa. This is on the Rideau Canal, and now we're home again. Joan and father working in the garden. This is an early Christmas on Purcells Cove Road. Joan got her ski boots. Some train switches there and airplane models. Joan has her globe. This is music by father here on the guitar. Triumph and Tragedy, one of Churchill's books. Thank you. this is the Howlands that we used to visit a lot, and they had a raft of dogs there. Now the boy there, Robbie, in the foreground, he was drowned in the oil rig disaster about two years ago, I think in 1983, 84. And he had visited Father just a week prior to him being drowned on that oil rig. Armitage boy, Kenny Armitage again. Cloud, who lives next door now to me. Great old times. Barry was my best friend from the beginnings. It's 1949 when we came to Canada. He's still a darn good friend. This is another Christmas, and I have a feeling that these Christmases are in the reverse order. Thank you. Paula Can here, I believe. And this is a quick shot of Earl Boatler, Barry McLeod, John Can. And again, Paula Can. Don't remember the occasion on that. It could be the Rainbow Haven sale. It's Mary Lou and Paula. This is the Rainbow Haven sale. Stuart Ronald, Earl Boatler, Sreeni, Mary Lou, and Joan. With Dog. This was sailing father and Matt Grant and mother on the Marita. This is just off Halifax Harbor, the lighthouse bank there. His mother on board. And loving every minute of it. Matt Grant, behind mother. Very good friend of the family. And there's the Marita. That's the Howlands and Barry and Mr. Howland. Joan riding at the Wentz. And I think this is about the end of our film. Great shot of Joan. I definitely wanted to get this in.